Hello everybody, and welcome back in the shop. Today, it is about the bandsaw. Okay, I skipped ahead a bit, where it has already taken shape. But have a look back here. There was a change of plans. Last time I was intending on using this little motor, which comes from a blender of some sort, to power this with. And as you may have seen in the last video, I even mounted that back there, directly on this shaft, using a flexible coupling. Well, there is my coupling. It is now in two pieces. Well, this proved to be a bad idea, as these couplings are cut in a spiral around the center hole. Something like a spring. In this case, I even drilled the center hole from 8 to 12 mm. Leaving back even less material for that spiral. Then apparently my motor worked in the direction that flexes instead of compressing the coupling, and this thing happened. But this is not really the problem here. For those few seconds that this wheel spinned on this motor, it was bloody terrifying in here. Which got me thinking. Well, I don't know a whole lot about bandsaws. So I did some homework online and found out that a good speed to run a bandsaw is around 3000 feet per minute, blade travel. An average speed for a good working bandsaw. There are other variables such as your blade's TPI, the density of the wood you are gonna cut, and stuff, but don't worry, we are keeping 3000 FPM here. Now for a bit of math. 3000 feet per minute equals 914.4 meters per minute. Come on guys, I'm in Europe. And each of my wheels there is 19 centimeters in diameter. Which gives a circumference ...0.597 meters. So if you divide 914 by 0.6, I need around 1500 RPM. This is rotations per minute. Well, ...16,000 RPM, and this is the slow speed. And I know what you're thinking. You are not a very bright fellowship, are you? Thinking you could use that on the saw while having a tachometer in your first drawer. By the way, fun fact. As you may know, I am Greek. And tachometer is a Greek word, comes from tachis, meaning fast, or tachitis, meaning speed, and metro, which is both a measuring unit and the unit measuring distance, meter here. But whenever I try to say that in English, it just doesn't sound right. Tachometer. Tachometer. I just cannot say that. That's irony, right? Ironia. Anyway, I was hoping that this was more like 5000 RPM and that I would need something like 3, 3.5. So I could get it down to maybe 4 by choking the fitting voltage, and those 4 would get right on the sweet spot added some load when I was going for a cut. By the way, this is a DC motor. 220 volts enter this board here, and through plane rectification you get your low speed. And the whole thing rectified gives you your high speed here. So this whole thing did not go as expected. And I am looking for a 10 to 1 reduction here, which you cannot do through your power supply, cause it would drop your torque dramatically, even if you used pulse width modulation. I could use a belt and pulleys to get that reduction, but for even this tiny fella up here, I would need the 25 cm diameter pulley on my shaft, which doesn't fit. My wheel here is 19. And using more than one belt, it just makes things too complicated, for no good reason. This thing is too fast to hold the belt in the first place, more likely. So, in lack of a better solution, I use the battery-powered hand drill to power this with, which also has some serious flaws. It is running slow, but it is still a better solution than using one of these corded drills. And let me tell you why. This thing is definitely faster, and according to this little sticker here, can do 3000 RPM, which is fairly accurate. It can also do a max of 2.6 amps. And the way this works, when I press the trigger, it gradually increases rotation speed until it hits the target. Then I put my hand and brake it. It draws all 2.6 amps, trying to resist me, but finally I beat all 550 watts, single-handed.
Okay, you subscribe now, or I squeeze you.
Okay, stay with me. Now this is a cheap, Chinese, battery-powered 18-volt hand drill. The corded one back there carries a rather heavy brand name. Now have a look here. This is a tough one. So what did you saw there? I pressed the trigger and the poor thing was already in top speed. And it is not much, just 700 RPM, which with no load draw a very small amount of current from the battery. Now whenever I try to brake it, it just increases the current drawn and it's working hard on maintaining that speed, until it has no more current to give. And it's a lithium battery, which means it must be using those 18x20 batteries that 9 out of 10 lithium powered things use. In fact, this one I think can do 30 amps. So we have two different things here. One is about power and the other one is about consistency, I don't know. Think of it as operating a DSLR camera. Aperture priority and shutter priority. So using this one would mean my bandsaw going crazy fast when having no load and slowing down when cutting depending on my feeds and speeds, while the other fella would always be fairly slow, but it will do its best to keep up with that speed. And don't get me wrong, it will also slow down if you exceed its limits, but it seems like a better choice for now. And to be honest, I don't really like the idea of using a hand drill to power this with, cause it requires power supplies and stuff. I like to keep it simple. But we will go with that for now, until we find a better solution. So that was all with this small update video. I hope you learned something new here today, and see you next time with the make. Until then, thank you all for watching, and have a nice one.